Where would we be without Google Maps? Well, lost. We'd be lost. In its relatively short existence, Google Maps has totally changed the way we navigate the world. We highly doubt you've been whipping out a map and compass lately. But Google Maps isn't merely a way to get from point A to point B. It's become a geospatial search engine for the world around us. There are tons of useful shortcuts and some really fun tools that you might not know about even if you use Google Maps, well, all the time. We're here to walk you through them. In light of the coronavirus pandemic, Google Maps unveiled a new tool that lets you see how crowded public transport is at a given time. Previously, you could see how crowded a bus or train would be expected to be at a given time. Now, it tells you how busy it is right now. If the feature is available in your area, searching for directions using public transit will now automatically feature information about how crowded the stations, buses, or trains are. Google Maps can do this by using data from other map users to work out just how many phones, and therefore humans, are riding the rails. You know that Seinfeld episode where they spend the whole episode trying to find their parking spot? That episode wouldn't work anymore, thanks to Google Maps. There's actually a specific way to save your parking spot on the mobile version of Google Maps. On Android, tap the location dot and hit Save Your Parking, which will add a label of your parking spot to the Maps app. You can tap that label to add details like the parking garage level, the specific parking spot, or how much time you have left before the meter runs out. You can also set meter reminders, add a photo of where you parked, and send your location to your friends. To find it later, just tap the search bar up top and select Parking Location. And to delete it, tap You Parked Here on the map, select More Info on the bottom left, and then tap Clear. On iOS, you can do the same thing by tapping the little blue location dot within the app when you arrive at the location. In the pop-up, tap Set as Parking Location. Then, in the app, a P icon will appear alongside a note that says You Parked Here. To get rid of it, just tap the P and select Clear. Let's be honest, we're not super interesting people. We all stick to the same few locations more than we like to admit, and Google Maps has a way of acknowledging that. You can build a custom map called My Map with all the locations and directions that are the most relevant to you. If you're signed in on desktop, just click on the hamburger menu, Your Places, Maps, Create Map. Once in the Maps feature, you can add pinpoints with info cards, highlight whole sections, or create customized walking or driving directions. You can also share your map or invite other people to edit it by clicking on the Share button in the top left corner. Over the years, Google Maps Street View has amassed a huge collection of street imagery. In 2014, Google launched a feature so users could see how Street View has changed over time. It's essentially a virtual time machine. In fact, Google literally dubbed the feature time travel. If you want to go back in time, go to Street View for whatever location you're trying to look at. From there, click on the little stopwatch icon in the top left corner. That'll prompt a scale that lets you jump through Street View over time. Just a heads up, the feature isn't available in all locations since it depends on how many photos Google has in its backlog. Even if you can't access it near you though, you can always go looking for other places to time travel. Right now, Maps is most useful on mobile, which brings up a problem. When you need Google Maps the most, you might find yourself in a location with limited or even non-existent coverage. We've all been there. Luckily, there's an easy fix. It just takes a little preparation. Navigate to the location you'd like to access while offline and tap the bottom of the screen. In the pop-up, select Download, and then download that map, assuming you have enough space on your device. Once the map downloads, you can get information about businesses in the region and turn-by-turn directions within the downloaded section. As you're probably aware, right-clicking anywhere on the map prompts a pull-down list with a ton of basic navigation options. But here's one fun, and maybe slightly unnecessary, one to add to your repertoire. If you right-click on a location, you can also calculate the distance of any two points on Earth. Just choose Measure Distance. This will drop a point which will be represented by a white dot with a bold black line. Then, click anywhere else on the map and the distance between the two points will be calculated. You can also switch between metric and US measurement by clicking on the scale in the footnote, and you can even add more points and move points around later. Honestly, it's just fun to play around with. You can search for wheelchair-accessible transit options by first typing in your desired destination in Google Maps, tapping directions, and selecting the public transportation option. Then, tap Options, and under the Route section, you'll find Wheelchair Accessible as a new option. This feature started its initial rollout in 2018 in London, New York, Tokyo, Mexico City, Boston, and Sydney, but people around the world are adding accessibility information for locations all over. Google's business model is built around digital services, and they're all free, kind of. Google supports their services by renting out your eyeballs to advertisers, which is something they're able to do by keeping a very detailed record of your digital activities. That includes everything you search for in Google Maps. You can look at this detailed online diary by going to myactivity.google.com. Hit filter by date and product below the search bar at the top. This will prompt a pop-up query in which you can search by date or Google product. If you want to see your past map search, click on the box next to maps and then the magnifying glass on the top of the screen. Here, you can see all of your past search queries and maps, including on mobile. If you want to delete all your searches, click the three dots to the right of the search bar at the top and choose delete results. Alternatively, you can click on an individual query and delete just that from your Google record. The makeup of cars on the road is changing, and Google Maps is changing with it. You can now search EV charging or EV charging station to find the nearest location to charge your electric vehicle. When you do, Maps provides information about the business where the station is located, charging speeds, what types of ports are available, and how many ports are at the location. You'll also see whatever information other drivers have left about the station, like ratings, photos, or other questions. Think you know more about your neighborhood than Google's algorithm? You might sign up to be a local guide, which anyone over the age of 18 with a Google account can do. Just Google local guide, Google Maps for sign-up info. Though anyone can leave reviews and other tips in Google Maps, joining local guides lets you earn points for leaving more insights and data that, as you go up the ladder, can result in early access to Google products, exclusive Google meetups, and even Google Drive space. Not too shabby. And now that you're a Google Maps expert, there's nothing stopping you from sharing all your knowledge with others.